Hello everyone. So on this channel, we don't strive to be skinny or lose weight, but rather make healthy choices to help us stay healthy and in shape, which is the best decision you can ever take, because eating healthy prevents that excess weight. You always stay in shape without excess weight like belly fat and the rest. So in this video, I'll be sharing with you this very yummy banana bread recipe. You can have as breakfast in the morning or snack on it. Very yummy and healthy as well to enable you live a very healthy life. So without wasting much of your time, as usual, I'll take you now and show you how to come up with yourself at home. Don't forget to share this video with your family and friends so we can all stay healthy, most importantly. So let's get into it. So in order to come up with a healthy, yummy banana bread recipe, the first ingredient we'll be using, of course, will be bananas. So for this recipe of today, we'll be using 2 large bananas. So you want your bananas ripe. If they are even more ripe than this, that is so fine, as it improves the taste and you don't need to add any extra too much sweeteners, because banana is naturally sweet and you with the healthy kind of sugar you need. So these are the 2 bananas. You want to get them in your mixing bowl and try to mash the bananas so it comes up like you achieve a paste out of the banana. When it gets to a smooth kind of consistency, know you are fine and you can start adding the other ingredients. The next ingredient I'll be adding in here would be either olive oil, coconut oil, or butter. So you can use any of them. If you are a vegetarian, you can use coconut oil, olive oil, but if you are okay, you can use butter. Butter is okay too. So, but for today, I'll be using coconut oil. So I'll be using 1/2 cup of coconut oil. So this is 1/2 cup of coconut oil I added into the 2 mashed bananas. This bowl is for my wet ingredients before I'll show you the dry ingredients. So I'll be adding in 2 eggs in here. This is so good to rise the cake, the bread, and give it moisture with the oil as well. So you want to add in 2 eggs for moisture. If you don't eat egg, you can just add a little bit more of the oil. If you don't eat egg, you just let me know at the comment section and I'll tell you how to substitute it. So I'll be adding vanilla flavor in here for good flavor and taste as well. So that is it. And I'll be adding in some honey. So I don't add sugar in my recipes because sugar can add calories. Like, you know, you're looking to stay in shape, you don't want to gain weight, you can use any other form of sweetener like stevia. Stevia has no calories. You can use honey. Honey is healthy sweetener, and avoid adding sugar. Like, use any healthy form of sugar. Honey is everywhere, but not white sugar. So the next thing I'll be adding in here will be yogurt. So if you don't have yogurt, you can skip it as well. I need yogurt for that moisture too as well to the cake, because the flour I'll be using is a little bit hard. So I need moisture and I'll be using a little bit of yogurt. That is 1/2 cup of yogurt. Now to the dry ingredients. So this bowl is for my dry ingredients. This is my brown flour. So I'll be using brown flour. And what I do is I always take time to sieve my flour. Like, I sifted it the first time and I'm doing it again the second time. So it doesn't, as you can see, this is brown flour, but I've gotten all that roughness. Like, I want it to really be smooth. So take your time and sieve. You can sieve like 2 times. And you achieve 2 cups of your brown flour. If you're using it, if you want the healthy recipe, go for the brown flour. They call it, it's wheat flour. So brown flour, wheat flour, very healthy as it is not processed. So that is the flour I'll be using. Or you can use oat flour. If you don't have this, you can use oatmeal, ground and turn into flour. I think I already shared a recipe using the oat flour. So if you don't have the wheat flour, you want to use oat flour, you can ask me and I'll link you up to the video with oat flour. But this is wheat flour I'm using today. So I'll be adding in some baking soda. So I just need to add 1/2 tablespoon of baking soda. This is 1/2 tablespoon of baking soda in here. And I'll be adding as well 1/2 tablespoon of baking powder. So these are to help the cake, the bread rise. These are to help
for like your cake to rise and not really. So you want to add half a tablespoon of each, making one tablespoon, and add half a teaspoon of salt. So that is salt. I am adding half a teaspoon of salt. You want to mix up your dry ingredients well, so those, the baking powder or baking soda, doesn't concentrate somewhere and you eat it and feel it in your mouth after you bake your cake. So you want to, your bread, so you want to mix well. And now these are the wet ingredients I want to mix before adding the dry ingredients in here. So you want to mix, take your time and really mix, so the all the ingredients get one smooth consistency. So you mix. This stage is very important, to really mix your ingredients well. And you can now start adding in your flour and mix. So I'll not be, let me get my wooden spoon and use my wooden spoon to really mix this so it gets smoother faster. So yeah, you want to just take your time and mix in a circular motion, like just one direction, just mix. So it rises, very important. So if you mix and get this consistency, know it is okay for you to bake now. So this is the best consistency, this thickness. Know you achieve a very beautiful bread at the end. But usually I like to add raisins or some like dry coconut flakes. I always add something in my bread. So for today, I'll be adding my coconut flakes. This is optional. If you don't have it, that is okay. This is just something I usually just add in my bread to make it taste really good, like I am eating cake. Like I don't feel like I am suffering because I want to be healthy. Like just to spice things up. And I use these flakes, or I use raisins, different other healthy spice up ingredients I add in my cake. Yeah, let me put it that way. So this is it. You mix, and this is it. Best consistency. And I'll be transferring in my bowl now to bake. So before mixing these ingredients, I set my oven to 375 degrees Fahrenheit. So that is my pan, my baking pan. You can use grease, like from your butter, to grease the pan, or if you have a baking sheet, you can use it to like prevent the cake or the bread from sticking up to your pan, so it is easy for you to like take it out after it is ready. So this is it in the oven. I'll bake for like 30-35 minutes. So after 30 minutes, make sure you come and check. After 30 minutes, you check. If it is not like this, you leave for another 5 more minutes. And after 35 minutes, you should achieve this, because I think I baked this for 35 minutes, and you should come up with something like this. Very good and tastes so good in the mouth. So this is it. This is my healthy, yummy banana bread recipe. You can try yourself at home. Very healthy. You can substitute the brown flour with oat, as I mentioned earlier, and you will love it. Share this video with your family and friends so we can all stay healthy, in shape, and live a very healthy life. Thank you for your time. Thank you for watching, and see you again in my next video. Bye. And don't forget, you can snack on this, substitute all those bad chips, all those high calorie snacks. You can actually have this as your snack as well in the afternoon. You can have it as your breakfast in the morning with your tea. Like, this is so healthy, like the best option for breakfast, healthy alternative for breakfast and snacking as well. So thank you for your time. Thank you for watching, and see you again in my next video. Bye.